we found one problem of DC measurement. The DC measurement takes several tens of seconds for getting the electrical characteristics. So our senior project is designed to our goal is to design a proper electrical measurement system for blockchain security electric register. And by using the system, we will investigate intrinsic electrical characteristics of blockchain security register. So to achieve our goals, we will use three measurement tools: pulse generator, a semiconductor power meter analyzer, and otoscope. And we will synchronize these three instruments by using LabVIEW program and GPIO cable. And this schematic diagram shows, briefly shows our the triangle pulse measurement system. By using this system, we will concurrently apply the triangle pulse to the gate and the constant bias to drain. And then by using an oscilloscope, we will get electrical characteristic of the graphene field register. So the purpose of triangle pulse is to control the total measurement time. So when we switch bias pipe fiber to fiber during the winding time, and we will switch fiber to bias fiber during the falling time of triangle pulse. So by controlling the rising and falling time, we will control the total measurement time. So this plot shows the differences between DC measurement and pulse measurement characteristics. In conclusion, we will investigate interesting electrical characteristics of graphene transistor, and this work will have positive effect on the development of graphene-based device engineering. Thank you. Graphene transistor can be used the digital modulator or RF devices, because graphene device can be operated at very high operating frequency. So there are lots of applications for graphene.
So you already got results then?
Yeah, actually, so we already got this result, but we did not build a program. So we got this graph by using our hand. So we will make a system. We will make a system to get this electrical characteristic automatically.
You compare at least the previous results that you see and have seen that this method should be better.
Right.
So what's the vertical axis on the graph today? What unit is that?
This one?
Yeah. What's the vertical axis? Y axis.
The y-axis are total. It means the channel distance of graphene affinity. Okay. So it can show the conductance, how many drain current is conducted all around.
And what are the two different traces? There's one color, the black color has two different pulses shown, and then the red has the position.
No, the black line shows the DC characteristic, and red line shows the triangle pulse characteristic. But in the DC characteristic case, as I said before, it takes the total measurement time is about several tens of seconds, okay. About 20 seconds. So DC measurement sweep the gauge voltage like this. But in the triangle pulse gate case, it can sweep like this. We can control the gate voltage sweeping it. And then the line time can be reduced to up to 10 microseconds. So to get this red line, the total measurement time is about 20 microseconds. Actually, the overall performance depends on the there are very big variation between the device to device variation. So by extracting the tenure quantity from the context-specificity, we can correct the permutation steps. Now, tenure quantity can be extracted from the model.
Strikes me your project is to characterize a single command, okay, this graphene fed, okay,
right.
And that's your entire, you're going to do senior design one and senior design two, to characterize a single command.
Oh, no, so if it is possible, we will get some more stuff and other devices and we will want to compare.
So you're planning on, you've basically got an approach that is synchronizing three measurement tools to measure a component,
right.
And then you're going to compare that against other known components with known characteristics, and then what are we going to do about that? I guess what I'm asking is the intent to say that your system is a better way of